obviously had to look at the landing and stuff, and really just trying to do what I can to help out. Sometimes I'm not very good at hitting deadlines, but they make a nice sound as they fly by. But the main computer that I'm using was the one that I got in college. I ended up spending a good amount of parents' money for that. And it was my workhorse, and it had started experiencing some problems, crashing randomly, and it really wasn't helping me out. And, you know, by now it's 4 or 5 years old, and I was like, you know, God, it's not worth anything, but I need a new computer, and I need to be portable so I can take this with me to Mark's house or wherever I'm going. And it was just so awesome that Al's stealing it in the back. That even though it was damaged, I put it on Kijiji just with everything that I knew was in it and what was going on. And this Mac store in London gave me a call, and they said, we'll give you $1,500 plus tax for a new computer if you bring it in here. And so I got the highest end Mac laptop that I need for $100 plus tax out of my pocket.
Meant to go to Pakistan in October, and I was a little bit kind of like, oh God, what's up? Because only about, not only, but about $1,800 had come in so far, which is kind of enough almost to get my plane ticket, but that's about it. And then Bimbi, actually, a pastor from England, who I've missed a couple times, said that, phoned me up and or emailed me and said, some good news, the Lord has spoken my heart, and we're sending you over $2,000. Woo! So that's pretty cool. So that just sealed the deal. And I just put it in the newsletter as well. And then the same day, I got a phone call from another church in Michigan that said, the Holy Spirit told me to, the pastor phoned me and said, the Holy Spirit told me to invite you over to preach, and you can take up an offering for Pakistan. So I'm going to do that on Sunday night in August, as well as another church in Toronto. About 250-300 people is going to take an offering for me as well for Pakistan.
All right.
And so that's pretty good. And there's still more money in the mail coming in. So I'm definitely going. So just pray for my safety and just continue to pray that God will just set me up. And I'm just confident that He's going to bring me home. And so that's the deal. Pakistan is about 2%, under 2% Christian. Tons of Muslims and a few other minority religious, mostly Muslim, though. And it is where the Al-Qaeda is centralized and located, I believe, as well. It's one of the main countries for that. So bringing the gospel into hostile territory, but you know, Jesus is bigger than all of that stuff.
Yep.
And I'm confident that He will keep me in the palm of His wing, the palm of His wing, the palm of His hand.
I think we heard Pastor Pickett talk about how God's love is unconditional for us. He loves us no matter what we do. But the blessing of God is conditional. You know, we have to live a certain way and God blesses us. And Daniel was doing such a good job for King Nebuchadnezzar that King Nebuchadnezzar wanted to make him the vice president, so to speak. And so the other guys were kind of jealous of Daniel. And you know what they noticed about Daniel? Daniel prayed 3 times a day. 3 times a day he prayed. Now King Nebuchadnezzar didn't know that, but these other guys did. And so they wanted to entrap Daniel. And they said, hey King, we thought of this really good idea. We think that you should make a rule that anybody who worships or prays to anyone other than you should be thrown in the lion's den. And the king was feeling a bit full of himself. And he said, yeah, that's a good rule. I like that. I'll sign that into law. So he did that. And after he signed it into law, these guys followed Daniel. And Daniel went home. You know what he did? He prayed. Like he always did. He was consistent and his relationship with God. And so these guys told King Nebuchadnezzar, hey, King Nebuchadnezzar, Daniel is breaking the law. Now the king's in a tough spot because he likes Daniel. And he tries to get Daniel off the hook. But these guys come before the king and say, King, you made the law yourself. So the king was pretty sad about that. Because the king is a just king. He won't go back against his word. And God is like that. God's a just God. He won't go back on his word. So they threw Daniel in the lion's den. Guys, what's going on? They threw Daniel in the lion's den. Guess what happened?
He made himself a big hairy pet.
Anybody who's gone to Sunday school knows the story. But Daniel didn't get eaten. And King Nebuchadnezzar rushed down there in the morning. And you know what the king said? The king said, Daniel, who continuously serves the living God, are you still alive? Daniel said, I am. So they pulled Daniel out of that lion's den. And the people that condemned Daniel, the people that entrapped him, they got thrown in the lion's den instead. They didn't fare so well. And I guess the reason I wanted to share that biblical story tonight is because there are times in our life where Satan will want us to compromise. But you know, God's got your back. And if you'll just be consistent with God, he'll rescue you. Because he can't go back on his word.
Yeah.
If he said he'll save you, he'll save you. Does anybody have their Bible with them? I strongly recommend you bring your Bible to church.